Well, it's been a very interesting 48 hours since my latest video premiered. The video is already well on its way to 1,000 views, not that I really give a shit. I got flagged off of Twitter for the 6th or 7th time, likely by some worthless fantard of the subject of my latest video. And on top of all of that, said subject of my latest video, David Jaffe, made a really bad response to the video in question. So I'll go ahead and do this one and likely only response to his response before I wash my hands of this entire thing and move on. I said everything I wanted to say in my hour and a half long video about Jaffe, and I stand by every single syllable of every single word in the video and regret not even a microbe of any of it. Anyways, let's see what Jaffe has to say.
There's a guy who made a video about me. It was so weird. I saw it on Twitter. He says, come to my stream, fellas.
It wasn't a stream. It was a video that at the time of the posting on Twitter that you alluded to was set to premiere 11 hours from when I posted about it. Please get your facts straight.
And I'm going to expose the truth about David Jaffe. He's an asshole, or he's a charlatan. I don't know what the fuck he called me.
Pretty sure what I said was, and I quote, witness me shitting on legendary game designer and shitty YouTuber David Jaffe for an hour and a half. And that's exactly what I did. Did I expose you to be a charlatan? No, not really. An asshole? Most definitely.
And I said, well, this sounds interesting. I'd like to have the truth exposed. But he was being a real dick at first.
This is awfully funny given what's revealed later in your response, but we'll get to that in a minute. And was I being a dick? Absolutely, because that's what I felt you deserved given all the instances of dickishness on your end, especially with all your disingenuous bullshit on Twitter about being respectful.
But this idea that it's like, oh, it's hurting. Somebody on my fucking chat was like, oh, we love games and we're trying to protect the medium for the future. Fuck you. Fuck you.
Holy shit, just look at that leaning tower of respect.
And so I reached out to him and I said, hey, if you clearly got an issue with me, why don't we have a conversation? Why don't we talk about it? Because clearly you got a problem and I don't know who you are. Let's talk. I don't want to fucking talk to you. You've lost the right for discourse with me, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, okay.
Yep. And you want to know why you lost the right to have any discourse with me? It's because, like I showed in my hour and a half long video, I've seen how you conduct yourself in the comment section whenever people do come to you to have a conversation about some of the stupid shit you say. And all you do is sidestep and perform all these shitty mental gymnastics to get out of potentially having to admit that you're wrong about whatever it is you said. Sorry, but it's not on my agenda list to go back and forth with a pseudo-intellectual that performs a bunch of shitty mental gymnastics in a pathetic attempt to not admit that they're wrong. I no longer have the time nor the patience to beat my head against the wall with people like you. That's why at a certain point, I'll just straight up block you when it's shown that you're not going to contribute anything of value to a conversation and will just continue to be a slobbering moron. That's why I keep my interactions with PC gaming socialists to the barest of bare minimums.
So he runs his movie. And this, think about this. This is a guy I've never talked to in my life. Talk about owning real estate in somebody's head for free.
Just like all these supposed entitled and toxic gamers own so much real estate in your mind that you dedicate several stream segments / videos to bitching about them. Just like how I purchased real estate in your mind that you dedicated some time to me, despite you implying on Twitter that you weren't going to? Yeah, exactly. Nice try, Chump Stain, but I can play that game too. I knew you were full of shit when you implied that you were just going to ignore me. After all, your pride and ego simply wouldn't allow that.
It's a 90-minute movie. He made a feature film about how much he hates me. And I didn't watch it. I scrubbed through it just to kind of be like, what's the, I get what this is.
So you didn't watch my video, yet here you are responding to my video that you didn't watch anyway? Yeah, that's a real smart thing to do. What happened to that whole, I'd like to have the truth exposed shit you said earlier? Was the hour and a half long length just too much for you to handle? Man, oh man, I cannot wait to see how him not watching my whole video is going to blow up in his face momentarily.
But I'm just like, that's a lot of work this guy put in. And like, you must either really hate me. But then I saw his, he calls himself the Great Exposer. And the funny part about it is he has a logo of like a dude holding up his jacket, like a naked dude, but you just see his from the back. So he clearly has a character that he plays, called the Great Exposer, which means now, okay, I get it. It's like, that's your shtick. Like, if you were just some random dude on the internet who's like, I fucking hate David Jaffe, I have to make this video, and I'm going to give up all my time to make this video about how much I hate this motherfucker, I'd be like, okay, wow, this guy really hates me. This guy's just trolling for anything. I mean, you don't go out and make a logo and make a channel with the title built around the idea of you're going to expose people unless you're basically going, okay, who's next? That's my character I play. That's my heel turn on Raw, right? So...
Except if you took even a cursory look at my channel, you'd see that not every video I make is dedicated to exposing people, as there are also skits and gameplay streams on my channel. Sure, I'm not going to sit here and try to bullshit you by saying that the majority of my content isn't dedicated to exposing people, but it's not all of it. Plus, if there weren't so many low-down cretins on this site to go after, you'd probably see a whole lot less of that type of content on my channel. As for me playing a character, I'd say only 10 to 20% tops is me portraying a character. The rest of the 80 to 90% is exactly the kind of interaction you'd get with me if you met me in person. Is it really trolling when you're telling the truth? Personally, I don't think so, but your mileage may vary.
It's really kind of dorky, it's really kind of old-fashioned, but whatever. So the guy makes this fucking thing. And the funniest part, what I got from this video was he doesn't like a lot of my gains. And he says, Jaffe, you're washed up and you don't make good video games, or you never did, or you haven't in a while. And honestly, what I took away from this that I found absolutely fascinating is my response to that was, huh, you may be right. He may be right. And I'm okay with that. My gut tells me I'm probably not good or not good enough at making multiplayer online games. I spent the last 8 years of my career trying to do that. I had a vision. It never really worked. And I wasn't that great at it. I couldn't compete. But I do think maybe I still have some things to say in the single player realm that are pretty innovative and interesting and relevant. But you know what? It's okay. Let's assume that's not even true. It may be a generational thing. Why is that the greatest crime? Why would it be the greatest crime if after 20 years in the industry, I made some games people loved, I made some games people didn't love, I had a lot of fun, I got paid really well, I didn't screw anybody, it's not like I ripped people off, we basically delivered our games, we were more than happy to give refunds if they weren't happy with them. I think it's a generational thing, or it's a thing where if you've never had any success in your own life, you can't fathom having success because you covet it so much, and then what it must be like to lose it, right? My very best days of cultural relevancy in games or in the world, other than the people I interact with as a family and friends group, those may be over, but that's okay. Why, you know, again, back to this Taylor Swift documentary. So I know a lot of people mock me for liking Taylor Swift. I think she's great. I'm watching this documentary last night. She says something, you know, this is one of the most, she's probably the most successful pop artist in the last 20 years. One of the most successful of all time. But she just turned 30 and she says, you know, there's a point where the public just doesn't let you keep doing this. And she's like, and I'm approaching that point. There's a point where it's like, look, you've gotten to have success at this level for so long, and now we need something new and shiny, and you can only invent yourself and reinvent yourself so many times. And it's like, yeah, it's okay. So it's weird to me that this guy's making this video and he's like, I'm going to expose Jaffe. I'm like, shit, did I do something? Did I fuck a corpse? What the fuck did I do? What the fuck did I do?
You see, Jaffe, this right here is a damn good reason why you don't fucking respond to a video you didn't even bother to completely watch. Had you actually bothered to watch the video, you would have found that my distaste for the majority of your game design output is only one of the multiple problems I have with you. And even that was more of a build-up to the biggest issue I have with you, That being, you have this air of arrogance that even the slightest bit of negative criticism towards you or any game you've made sends you into a petulant tism frenzy. Like I showed in my video where you flew off the handle at some podcasters simply because they said they wanted a new Twisted Metal game without your involvement. You have this fucking attitude problem that is 100% unearned because your overall game design track record is spotty at best, yet based on how you conduct yourself, you seem to think otherwise. Are you beginning to see why I wanted nothing to do with any personal one-on-one dialogue with you? You don't even have the basic goddamn intelligence to watch a video all the way through before responding to it, so how the fuck am I to expect to get any sort of meaningful conversation with you? No, see, instead, you're gonna pick out the easiest thing in my video to address because you damn sure don't want any part of the rest of it because it makes you look like the rabid dipshit you are, and are just gonna sit there and feign ignorance and be like, "What did I do? I didn't do nothing." That reminds me of somebody else who likes to play the victim and feign ignorance when it comes to their own bullshit, but I can't seem to remember their name at the moment. Oh wait, it's your bosom buddy, NextGen 720. He does the same exact type of bullshit you're doing right now. You wanted to talk about how toxic this whole thing is over Twitter, yet you're still doing podcasts with Zaire, who is one of the most toxic motherfuckers in this entire community, yet you're gonna sit there and think you have any solid ground to stand on when it comes to talking about toxicity? Yeah, you're really motivating me to want to have a one-on-one chat with you, pal. Since you didn't want to take the time and due diligence to actually watch my entire video before responding to it, I'm not even going to bother with the rest of your shitty response, and instead, I'll go ahead and close this video by addressing the dipshit Jaffe fanboys that have recently flooded my video. It seems like the typical clockwork, malformed, cheap complaint these simians have latched onto is that I'm somehow mad that Jaffe has done something with his life, whereas I haven't. No dipshits, you're mad that I took your idol down a peg. And since you all have nothing of any significance going on in your lives other than worshiping a washed-up has-been game designer you don't even personally know, you have taken my attack on him as an attack on you. Which if that's how you want to perceive it, go right ahead. None of you know a damn thing about me or my position in life that I'm more than happy with. Even though I've made said position very known and openly public on my channel. Even with my piddly ass channel, I've gotten to know people on YouTube that I'm a big fan of that have a significantly bigger following on YouTube than Jaffe, some of whom have expressed being a fan of my own work. Sure, I haven't made any well-known games, but I've accomplished quite a bit with my YouTube channel, more than I ever thought I would and much more than I actually sought out to do. Meanwhile, what have any of you pathetic sacks of shit done other than make sure Jaffe's e-knob has been fully polished? It's probably partially because of you idiots fanboying over and enabling his behavior that he is the way he is. So in that aspect, y'all might arguably be even worse than he is. It's because of people like you that these actors who play pretend for a living get such big heads and think they can preach to the common man about how they should live. You're deifying people who put on clothing exactly the same way you do, and it's embarrassing. Tell me something, dipshits. If I was mad that Jaffe has done something significant with his life, why would I have given him his props for making three good Twisted Metal games at the beginning of my video? That's not exactly behavior becoming of somebody that would be mad and or jealous of somebody else for the good they've done in their life, now is it? The other big point of contention other than this and the whole why didn't I personally confront Jaffe thing, which I already addressed, is the Herculean length of the video itself. I had a few Jaffe fantards in the premiere chat whining about how the video is too long and how it didn't need to be that long. There's only one person who decides how long my videos need to be, and guess what? It ain't any of you clowns. Neither you nor Jaffe himself stopped to think that maybe the video was that long, not only because I had a lot to say, but because it was also a trap. A trap that Jaffe himself fell into, hook, line, and sinker. Now how could mere video length be a trap? Simple. I know that people normally have a hard time sitting through videos that are over an hour in length. However, I also know somebody like Jaffe can't resist addressing something negative about him. So what does he do? He scrubs over my video and picks the most convenient thing from said video to address and portrays that one convenient thing as what the entirety of my video was about, and thus makes an utter ass out of himself and only further validates and justifies my video about him. Basically, he was fucked either way. He could either sit down and watch the entire video and dedicate just as much time to addressing everything I said in the video, if not more, which would completely destroy his whole real estate argument, or he could not watch most of my video, yet try to respond to it anyway and make himself look like the doofus that I accurately portrayed him to be in my video. Needless to say, he chose the latter and made my video that much stronger as a result. So yeah, like I said, I'm probably not going to respond to any more of his nonsense. Not only do I feel 100% satisfied with my initial video, but his idiotic response to it only proved the points I made in said video even more. Y'all Jaffy fantards can go ahead and continue to cry and downvote all you want. This is a clear victory for me regardless of how you want to spin it. As for what's next for me, I really don't know. Maybe I'll make a video about the recent JTEC TV sex scandal that's been going on Twitter. Or maybe I'll just go dark again for another several months like I did last year. Who knows? Either way, y'all know I'll be back eventually. The Great Exposer has spoken.